Hello everyone, Alex here from warrantoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can private message a user depending on when they send you a message, as well as how you can private message a user if you have their Discord ID. So to get started, I have this very basic application here. You can clone this from the GitHub repository, but you likely have similar code already. So I'm going to make a new file. This will be called private-message.js. I'm then going to export a function. This is going to have a client, it's going to have a trigger text and a reply text. So the trigger text is what we're going to be listening for. So if they send that exact text, then we're going to send them the reply text. So in this example, we're going to say, if they say ping, we're going to reply with pong in a private message. So to do this, we can say client.onMessage. This is going to listen for whenever a message is sent. We're then going to get a message object. We're going to say, if message.content.toLowercase is exactly equal to triggerText.toLowercase. In this exact case, we're going to say message.author.send reply text. So if we go back to our index file, we can import this constant private message equals require private message. And then we can initialize a new private message passing in the client, the trigger text being ping and the reply text being pong. That'll then save all of our files. We can then run our bot with node index.js. We go into Discord. We see our bot is online. It's a tutorial bot. Inside of this testing channel, we can say ping and send us a message saying pong. Now, going back to Visual Studio Code, there's a few things I want to do here. The first one is to see if we can actually detect whenever they send us a private message or just a message in a public channel. So if we say ping in here, it still works. However, what if I exclusively want to do that? Well, we can simply add if message.channel.type, which returns a string, if that's exactly equal to DM. If we save this and we restart our bot, we can then go back into Discord. If we say ping, it says pong again. However, if we go into our public testing channel, if we say ping, nothing actually happens. So you can check if this is a private channel or if it isn't a private channel by doing that. Another option we have is if we want to be able to send a private message, if we have just their Discord ID, and we do not have them sending a message right there. So if we go ahead and close this, we're going to write this simply right here. We can say client.users.fetch. We have to pass in an ID. Going back to Discord, if you have developer mode enabled on your account, you can right click a profile and you can copy the ID. And then I can paste that in here. So now this returns a promise. So we can use dot then, and we get a user object back. We can say user.send hello world. So if we save this and we restart our spot, we're gonna have an exact message right here. There it is right there, hello world. So that is one way you can send a message to a user, a private message, if you have just their Discord ID. And in some cases you'll need this, and in other cases you'll be able to just use the message.author or another type of user object. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warrantoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.